Today, I'll show you how you can use Excel's filter function to check for multiple criteria. For example, you need to check who works in the finance department and is also in the productivity division. So your criteria is in two different columns. And the technique I'll show you can be used on two or more columns. I'll also cover how you can check for two different things in the same column. For example, you want to check the names and salaries of people who are either in finance or in the sales department. We're going to wrap up the tutorial by also learning how you can tweak the filter function to extract only the columns that you need, so you don't return all those columns that you don't need. Let's get to it. Okay, so here's our data set. We have information about different divisions. So we have utility, productivity, and the game division, the name of the persons working in those divisions, the department they're in, and the yearly salary. This data is formatted as an official Excel table, and I've called it table div. What I want to do is this. I want to figure out the list of people that work in the productivity division and they're part of the finance department. How can we do this with a filter function? Let's get started with filter. The array is what we want returned. So in the first instance, let's just return everything just to make sure our analysis is correct. And then I'm going to show you how you can select specific columns. Next is the include argument. Well, we want to include everyone that works in the productivity division. So I'm going to select the data in the division column and check whether this equals productivity. Now we're not done because we also want to include everyone in the finance department. But before I move on to that, let's just close the bracket and make sure our formula works so far. And it does. We're only returning information from the productivity division. Okay, so far so good. Let's now include the finance department. So can I just move on to the next argument and have the next include? I can't. Why? Because the next argument is an if empty optional argument. This is something you can populate to tell it what you want returned if it doesn't find anything. So for example, if there was no one in the productivity department, I can just put in quotation, quotation, which means return nothing instead of returning an error. So to be able to solve this, I have to tweak this include argument. And the way you do that is like this. You're going to put the first check inside brackets. And because we're going with an and condition, we're going to multiply this with our second check, which checks whether the department is finance. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to hover over department, check whether this equals to finance, and close the bracket. Now, you're probably wondering,
what am I doing here?
Why am I multiplying these with one another? Well, here's why. So I'm just going to select this so we can see what is being returned. And because I have Excel for Office 365, I don't need to use the F9 key to debug this. We can already see the result on top here. Notice what we get. We have false, true, true, true. Where is this coming from? Well, take a look at our division column. The first one is utility, then productivity, and so on. Is cell A2 equals productivity? No, that's why we get false. These are all true. That's why we return true. The same type of check is done on this side as well. Here we're checking whether department equals finance. So in the first case, we have a true because it is equal finance, and then we have false, and then true, and so on. Now, the reason we multiply these with one another is that the moment you perform any mathematical operation on Boolean values, you change these to numbers. So a true becomes a 1 and a false becomes 0. And this is what you get. And here, if I hover over this, we can see the result pop up on top. So why do I have a 0 in the first two cases? Because this was false, this was true. 0 multiplied by 1 is 0. Here we have true multiplied by false, again 0. But look at this, we have a true multiplied with true, so 1 multiplied by 1, we get a 1 back. And the pattern continues. Ultimately, the include argument returns everything that's not 0. And that's why we end up with this result. You can, of course, build on this to include more and arguments. If, for example, we only wanted to include those that have a salary over 100,000, we can just multiply this with our next check, which is yearly salary is greater than 100,000. Close bracket, press enter, and that's it. Okay, so I'm going to press Control Z to go back. Now, I have a question for you. What if I didn't want an and argument? Instead, I wanted an or argument. So either division is productivity or department is finance. How do you think we can tweak this formula? All we need to do is change this to a plus, and that's it. We have either finance or productivity. They can, of course, also occur together. Now, how does this work? Well, this time we're adding ones and zeros with one another. So again, this gives us true-false values. This also gives us our true-false values. And when we combine them together, we get ones and twos and zeros. So the twos are for when both conditions are met. Ultimately, the include argument returns all the non-zero values, and that's why we end up with this result. Now, how do we go about returning only the columns that we need? For example, let's say I just want the name column and the yearly salary column back, and I don't want the division and the department columns. In a previous video, I've shown a trick you can use with a filter function, but since then, Microsoft has introduced a great new function that we can use to solve this, and that's called CHOOSECOLS. This gives us the ability to choose only the columns that we want returned. The array is going to be the result of this function, which is what we see here. And which columns do we want back? The second column and the fourth column. So I'm going to put 2. And then for the next column, I want 4, close bracket, press enter. And now we just get the names and the yearly salaries. Now, what if we wanted to sort this by salary in descending order? Again, another great function we can use here is the sort function. The array is the result, what we see here. We go all the way to the end and then decide what our sort index is. This is the column we want to sort this by. That's the second column. And the sort order, I want to go with descending. That's it, close the bracket, press enter. And I have my names and salaries sorted in descending order. Now I have a challenge for you. Let's see if you can solve this. I have the same data set, but I want to return the data where division is either game or utility. So notice both of these are in the same column. How can I do that? Let's see if you figured it out. I'm going to start off with a filter function. Array is what we want returned. Let's just return everything here. Include where this equals game. And remember, we said if we're looking for OR condition, we need a plus, right? So I'm going to continue with a plus. And again, select the same column if this equals this. Is this correct? Will I get the right result? Let's check it out. No, I don't. What's the problem with this formula? I'm missing the brackets. Brackets are super important when you have more than one criteria in the include argument of the filter function. Right? So whenever it's multiple criteria, remember to put in those brackets. Now we get the right result. We have either utility or game.
Ah, one more thing.
I have one other challenge. What if now I wanted to only include the results where salary is greater than 80,000? Well, we can combine this with the and condition, right? I can go here. Multiply, bracket open, yearly salary greater than 80,000. You can also reference the cell if you have it separately there. You're going to close bracket, press enter. This is correct, right? No, that's not correct. We have 45,000 here. What's the problem? The problem is our brackets. These belong together, and then we're going to multiply the result with our and condition. So here we need to put these inside their own brackets. And now check this out. Either utility or game, but everyone earns more than 80,000. Let me know how you did in the comments. Okay, so I hope this tutorial helps, because using the filter function with multiple criteria is a common question I receive from our community. And I have to say, it's not that straightforward to figure out. So I hope you found this helpful. If you did, give this video a thumbs up. I hope you are subscribed to this channel. If not, do consider subscribing, and I'm going to see you in the next video.